come to next theorem, theorem 7. If W is a subspace of a finite dimensional vector space V, every linearly independent subspace of W is finite and is part of a basis for W. So I think no need to do this one. This is obvious. Next, come to theorem 8. It is an important one. Let S is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha n be a basis of a finite dimensional vector space. S is a basis, and we have finite dimensional vector space Vf and of dimension n. Then every element alpha of V can be uniquely expressed as alpha is equal to a1 alpha 1 plus a2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus an alpha n, where a1, a2, so on, an, they are all belonging to F, means they are all elements of a field F. So this is a basis, and V is of dimension n, and any vector of V can be expressed as this one. Now we need to show that this is a unique expression. See its proof. Since we have a basis S of V, therefore LS will be V by the definition of a basis. Therefore, any vector alpha in V can be expressed as alpha is equal to a1 alpha 1 plus a2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus an alpha n. Now to prove that this is a unique expression, let us suppose that alpha can be written as b1 alpha 1 plus b2 alpha 2 plus 1 bn alpha n. And we need to show that a1 is equal to b1, a2 is equal to a2, and so on, an is equal to bn. Since both of them are the same vectors alpha, so a1 alpha 1 plus a2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus an alpha n is equal to b1 alpha 1 plus b2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus bn alpha n. It implies that a1 minus b1 alpha 1 plus a2 minus b2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus an minus bn alpha n is equal to 0 vector. And since alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha n, they are linearly independent, since they are basis, since they form a basis of V, therefore they are linearly independent. It means the all the coefficients are zero. Therefore, a1 minus b1 equal to zero, a2 minus b2 is zero, and so on, an minus bn is zero. Since alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha n, they are all linearly independent. It implies that a1 is equal to b1, a2 is equal to a2, and so on, an is equal to bn. And therefore, this expression is the same as this one. Hence, we get a unique expression for the vector, any vector alpha in V. So this theorem is proved. Next, we come to our next theorem. If W1 and W2, they are two subspaces of a finite dimensional vector space Vf, then dimension of W1 plus W2 can be written as dimension W1 plus dimension W2 minus dimension W1 intersection W2. See its proof. Suppose dimension W1 intersection W2 is a small k, and let the set S is equal to gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, so on, gamma k be a basis of this W1 intersection W2. Since its dimension is a small k, so its basis will contain small k elements. Therefore, this S will be a subset of W1, and also this will be a subset of W2, since it is a basis of their intersection. Now S is linearly independent, and S is a basis of W, and S is a subset of W1. Therefore, we can extend X S to form a basis of W1. S is not a basis of W1, S is a basis of W1 intersection W2, and we need to extend S to form a basis of W1. Let gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 1, gamma 2, so on, gamma k, and alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha m be a basis of W1. Then dimension W1 will be what? This total number of vectors in this set, so it will be k plus m. Similarly, let gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 1, gamma 2, so on, gamma k, and beta 1, beta 2, so on, beta t be a basis of W. Then dimension W will be what? W2, the total number of elements in this set, so it is k plus t. Therefore, dimension W1 plus dimension W2 minus dimension W intersection W2, it will be dimension W1 is m plus k, dimension W2 is k plus t minus dimension of their intersection is small k, so it is k plus m plus t. So this is our right hand side of the theorem. We need to show that this is equal to dimension W1 plus W2. To prove the theorem, we must show that this is equal to k plus dimension W1 plus W2 is equal to k plus m plus t. So our claim is that S1 is equal to gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 1, gamma 2, so on, gamma k, alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha m, and beta 1, beta 2, so on, beta t is a basis of W1 plus W2. This is our claim. If this is true, then the result is complete. First, we show that this S1 is linearly independent. let C1 gamma 1, remember the definition of basis. It should be linearly independent and span the vector space. Let C1 gamma 1 plus C2 gamma 2 plus 1 plus Ck gamma k plus A1 alpha 1 plus A2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus AM alpha m plus B1 beta 1 plus B2 beta 2 plus 1 plus Bt beta t is equal to 0 vector. So B1 beta 1 plus B2 beta 2 plus 1 plus Bt beta t can be written as minus times C1 gamma 1 plus 1 plus Ck gamma k plus A1 alpha 1 plus 1 plus AM alpha m on another side of equal to. Now minus C1 gamma 1 plus 1 plus Ck gamma k plus A1 alpha 1 plus 1 AM alpha m belongs to W1 since it is a linear combination of a basis of W1. See, in the basis of W1 contains these vectors. So this vector will belong to W1 because it is a linear combination of basis of W1. Again, B1 beta 1 plus B2 beta 2 plus 1 plus B2 beta t belongs to W2 since it is a linear combination of elements belonging to a basis of W2. And by virtue of the equality 2, this equality 2, B1 beta 1 plus 1 plus B2 beta t belongs to W1. Since this belongs to W1 and both of them are equal, so this will belong to W1 also. Therefore, B1 beta 1 plus B2 beta 2 plus 1 plus Bt beta t belongs to W1 intersection W2. See, it is in W2 and it is in W1, so it will be in their intersection. Therefore, it can be expressed as a linear combination of the basis of W1 intersection W2. Thus, we have a relation of the form B1 beta 1 plus B2 beta 2 plus 1 plus Bt beta t is equal to D1 gamma 1 plus D2 gamma 2 plus 1 plus Dk gamma k. Since gamma 1, gamma 2, so on gamma k is a basis of W1 intersection W2. So replace all of them to the left hand side. So it will be B1 beta 1 plus B2 beta 2 plus 1 plus Bt beta t minus D1 gamma 1 minus D2 gamma 2 minus 1 minus Dk gamma k is equal to 0 vector. But beta 1 to beta t and gamma 1 to gamma t, gamma k, they are linearly independent vectors. So we must have B1 equal to 0, B2 is equal to 0, and so on. Bt is equal to 0. Now substitute these values of B in equation 1 here. It will reduce to C1 gamma 1 plus C2 gamma 2 plus 1 plus Ck gamma k plus A1 alpha 1 plus A2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus AM alpha m equal to 0 vector. It implies that C1 will be 0, C2 will be 0, and so on, Ck will be 0. And A1 is 0, A2 0, so on, AM is equal to 0. Why? Because the vectors gamma 1 to gamma k and alpha 1 to alpha m, they are all linearly independent. Therefore, the relation will imply what? C1 is 0, C2 is 0, and so on, Ck is 0, A1 is 0, and so on, A2 is 0, A1 AM is 0. Similarly, B1 is 0, B2 is 0, and so on, Bt is 0. Therefore, the set of vectors, this gamma 1 to gamma k, alpha 1 to alpha m, and beta 1 to beta t, this is a linearly independent set. Now, to show that LS1 is equal to W1 plus W2, since W1 plus W2 is a subspace of V, and each element of S1 belongs to W1, W2, W1 plus W2, therefore, LS1 will be a subset of W1 plus W2, okay. Again, let alpha be an element of W1 plus W2, then alpha is equal to some element of W1 plus some element of W2. So it is equal to a linear combination of elements of basis of W1 plus a linear combination of elements of basis of W2. So it is equal to a linear combination of elements of S1. Therefore, alpha belongs to LS1. Hence, W1 plus W2 is a subset of LS1. Since alpha is in W1 plus W2 and we get to conclude that alpha belongs to LS1, so this will be a subset of LS1, and from this and this we get LS1 is equal to W1 plus W2. Thus, therefore, S1 is the basis of W1 plus W2, and therefore dimension W1 plus W2 will be small k plus m plus t, which was our target. Therefore, the result is, the theorem is proved. You can see there is a very good example. See this example. Let V be the vector space of all 2 by 2 matrices over the field F. Prove that V has dimension 4 by exhibiting a basis for V which has 4 elements. See its solution. Let V have 4 vectors alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Alpha is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0. Beta is equal to 0, 1, 0, 0. Gamma is 0, 0, 1, 0. Delta is 0, 0, 0, 1. They are 4 elements of V. The subset S is equal to alpha, beta, gamma, delta of V is linearly independent because A alpha plus B beta plus C gamma plus D delta is equal to 0 vector implies that a is equal to 0, b is equal to c is equal to 0, and d is equal to 0. See here, it implies that a into 1 0 0 0 plus b into 0 1 0 0 plus c into 0 0 1 0 plus d into 0 0 0 1 is equal to 0 0 0 0. Since right hand side is a 0 vector and v is the vector space of all 2 by 2 matrices, so this 0 vector will be 0 0 and 0 0. It implies that ABCD is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0. Therefore, all of them are 0. The coefficients are 0. Therefore, this subset S is linearly independent. Also, LS is equal to V because if ABCD be any vector in V, then we can write ABCD can be written as A alpha plus B beta plus C gamma plus D delta. Therefore, this S is the basis of V. And since S contains 4 vectors, therefore dimension V is equal to 4. So it is proved. See another example. There is one more example for you. See here. Let V be the vector space of ordered pairs of complex numbers over the field R. R means field of real number. So show that the set S is equal to 1, 0, I, 0, 0, 1, 0, I is a basis for V. For proving this to be a basis, we need to prove that it is linearly independent and it spans the vector space. First, it is linearly independent. See, a into 1, 0 plus b into I, 0 plus c, 0, 1 plus d, 0, I is equal to 0, 0. So it implies that a plus ib, c plus id is equal to 0, 0. It implies that a plus ib, 0 and c plus id, 0. And compare real and imaginary parts. So a is equal to 0, b is equal to c, 0 and d, 0. All of them are 0. Therefore, S is linearly independent. So now we show that LS is equal to V. Let any ordered pair A plus IB, BC plus ID belongs to V, where ABCD, they are real numbers. Then as shown, we can write A plus IB, C plus ID is equal to A into 1, 0 plus B into I, 0 plus C into 0, 1 plus D into 0, I. So this element of V is expressed as linear combination of the elements of this S. So LS is equal to V, and therefore this S is a basis for V. Why? Because this S is linearly independent first, and second, LS is equal to V. Means linear, this S is linearly span, linear span of this S is the vector space V. So this is also proved. You can have several other problems. And if you have any other query or doubt, you can ask me your questions.